Determine the derivatives of the given functions. For the first example, we have f of x equals 4, hyperbolic tangent 3x. Notice we do have a composite function, and therefore we do have to apply the chain rule. Looking at the formulas on the right, which include the chain rule, we have the derivative of hyperbolic tangent u with respect to x equals the square of hyperbolic secant u times u prime. In our case, notice u is equal to 3x, which indicates u prime or du dx equals 3. If it's helpful, we can think of the given function now as 4 hyperbolic tangent u, which indicates f prime of x equals 4 times the square of hyperbolic secant u times u prime. And now we substitute 3x for u and 3 for u prime, which gives us f prime of x equals, well, because u prime is 3, 4 times 3 is 12, we have 12 times the square of hyperbolic secant of 6x. For the second function, we have f of x equals the fourth power of hyperbolic cosine of 6x. In this case, it'll be helpful to write this as the fourth power of hyperbolic cosine 6x. In this form, we can easily identify the inner function as hyperbolic cosine 6x, which indicates u equals hyperbolic cosine of 6x. Notice this is also a composite function, which means to determine u prime, we'll also have to apply the chain rule. The derivative of hyperbolic cosine u with respect to x equals hyperbolic sine u times u prime, which indicates u prime equals hyperbolic sine 6x times 6, or 6 hyperbolic sine 6x. And again, if it's helpful, we can now think of the original function as simply u to the fourth, which indicates f prime of x is equal to 4 times u to the power of 4 minus 1, or u cubed, times u prime. And now we substitute hyperbolic cosine 6x for u and 6 hyperbolic sine 6x for u prime. This gives us f prime of x equals 4 times the cube of hyperbolic cosine 6x times u prime, which is 6 hyperbolic sine 6x. Simplifying, we have f prime of x equals 4 times 6 is 24, giving us 24 times the cube of hyperbolic cosine 6x times hyperbolic sine 6x. I hope you found this helpful.